In this video, we're going to start by talking about the physical reason that resistors dissipate power. Then we're going to calculate how much power resistors dissipate if there's a current flowing through them, and then we'll wrap things up with a simple example. So the picture we're looking at here on the top is a picture that I used in a video about drift velocity, and I'll post a link to that video real quick. I have the current pointing to the right, which means the electrons are actually moving to the left, and the average velocity of those electrons is called the drift velocity. And the key point here is that the drift velocity through this conductor is constant. So as these electrons move from a potential of zero to a potential of V, they're losing electric potential energy. But if the drift velocity is constant, it means their average kinetic energy is staying the same. Well, this means that the electrons must be losing energy overall, and that energy has to go somewhere. Where does it go? It's actually dissipated as heat, and this is the power dissipated by a resistor. Just a quick comment on the physical cause of what's happening here. The reason that the average velocity of electrons stays constant is because they're constantly running into the atoms of this conductive material. So it's just these super frequent collisions that keep stopping the electrons. And then the electric field through this conductor will accelerate them again, but they slam into another nucleus. So they never really get going faster and faster. They just end up with this constant drift velocity on average through the material. So now that we've established that there's an energy loss as the charge carriers go through a conductor, let's try to figure out how much energy and how fast. And so in the bottom picture, I've symbolically represented the resistor with the normal symbol for a resistor. I have a current of I. And one thing I should have labeled here is to say that on the high side of this, I'll have a potential of V, and on the low side, a potential of zero. And we're switching our perspective here. So even though we know that electrons are the charge carriers in a conductor, I'm just going to switch to the simpler model now that positive charge flows from high potential to low potential. It's just easier to think about. So what I'm going to do is allow a time of delta T to go by. And then I'm going to say during that time, a charge of delta Q must flow through the resistor. And again, the speed of these charges is not increasing as they flow downhill. That's our energy loss. So I'm going to write down the potential energy change of my charge delta Q. The general formula for that is Q delta V, but our charge is delta capital Q. And our delta V is final minus initial, which is zero minus big V. And I end up with negative delta Q times V. So there's our energy loss in a time of delta T. So that energy had to go somewhere. And where did it go? It increased the temperature of the resistor. In other words, this energy has been thermalized. So I can say the amount of energy dissipated as heat is going to be the opposite of this loss of energy of our charge carriers. And that's delta Q times V. And then finally, I want to find the rate at which this energy is being dissipated. That's the power measured in watts. And then I go, aha, delta Q over delta T, that's just I, the current. So I end up with this very important formula, P equals IV. And this formula applies extremely generally, so it's not just for resistors. This is the fundamental one. But if I want to think about tweaking this formula for resistors in particular, I can just remind you of Ohm's law, relating the potential difference across the resistor, the current, and the resistance. And this means I could replace the V in the power formula with IR and get I squared R. And that can be a useful formula when we're looking at power dissipated by a resistor. Finally, I can solve Ohm's law for I and write that I is V over R. If I replace this I with V over R, I get that the power dissipated by the resistor is V squared over R. Again, that top formula, P equals IV, applies to anything in which a current and potential difference is involved. The bottom two formulas apply only to resistors. Let's wrap things up by working an example. So I have a current of 0.85 amps running through a resistor with resistance 10.1 ohms. Compute the power dissipated by the resistor. Okay, so the variables that were given to us were I and R. So I'm going to use I squared R as my starting method here. And I get 0.85 amps. Squared times a resistance of 10.1 ohms. And I get a power of 7.3 watts out of this. It's also possible to turn things around with Ohm's law. So I know that V equals IR, and that allows me to find the potential difference across this resistor. So it's going to be 0.85 amps times 10.1 ohms. And I get, just keeping one extra decimal place, 8.59 volts. Then I can play with my other power formulas and write down that P is equal to IV, 0.85 amps times 8.59 volts. And again, I get 7.3 watts dissipated by the resistor. And then finally, just for the sake of completeness, I can use V squared over R, and that's 8.59 volts squared over the resistance of 10.1. And again, I get 7.3 watts dissipated by the resistor. If you find the physics content on Zach's Lab helpful, click on the Zach's Lab logo on the right to browse playlists and subscribe to the channel. I produce over 100 new videos per month, and subscribing is the easiest way to find new content. Thanks for watching.